This video is brought to you by Surfshark. Why do I look so serious? Because the protection of your internet is serious. Even though I mostly use Surfshark for the fact that I just like watching American and British Netflix, and it's easier to do that when you install it in your browser, pop it up in there, and just are like,
I'm an American now, this is cute.
But it does help protect your internet and encryption and all the cute computer science things that people know way more about than me. Surfshark has over 3,200 servers in 65 plus countries, so you have access to so many different IP addresses, it's not even funny. So if you wanna protect your internet, if you wanna browse on a different Netflix that's not in your country of residency, or if you wanna change your IP address just to say you did it, then download Surfshark VPN. You can get it by entering promo code MBOWE, that's M-B-O-W-E, to get 83% off and your first 3 months free. That's my favorite word. So click the link in my description, get your promo code, and start surfing the internet and protecting your internet. And let's get back to the video.
Hi. Hey, Neil. This is gonna be awesome, yo.
So we just gonna ignore that hate crime, huh?
I'm a dark elf or a drow.
Shouldn't you be wearing armor or something?
I'm an elf, not a nerd.
And welcome back to my channel. Sorry. I'm not really loving the intro anymore. Are we still loving the intro? Do I need to keep introducing myself or do I just say my name's Khadija and we get to the business? Let's comment below. Let's chat. Anyway, if you are new, feel free to take a look around, suss out the vibe. I just sit in this space and talk about whatever I feel like. And some of you may have clicked this video thinking you know what I'm going to say or my thoughts on this, but you
don't know me.
Wait, give it a moment. Watch first and then decide, okay? Y'all like this bun? I haven't had box braids for a minute. These are, what? Oh my God. As I mentioned in a previous video, I will be mixing my heavily dense, heavily researched topics with some more fun and chill, just me talking topics, because the burnout is real and a bitch is tired. So in keeping with that theme, today we're gonna talk about one of my absolute favorite episodes from one of my absolute favorite shows.
What did I do?
Everyone can see, Rory. Beat again. There's nothing standing in your way now, cause I'm out.
No.
I am 22 years old. I should not even be in here. This is some kind of mistake.
She's panicking. We need to clear the room.
I'm not leaving.
No.
Yesterday, you were normal. Today, you're Barbie. If Barbie rolled around in the mud and turned into a Negro.
Oh, not that one. Community! Y'all, you do not understand. I love Community so much. I have seen every episode probably 10 times over. I can quote every single one. Even the gaslight year I've watched more than once, okay? Because I need my Community fix. I just love it, okay? And I was a fan of the show probably when the second season came out is when I first got introduced to it. The Donde Está La Biblioteca, like that was the first thing I'd ever seen a Community. And I was like, what is this? This is genius, I must watch. But I assume that not everybody that is watching this video knows about Community, or if you do, it's always good to have a little bit of a reminder. So let me give you a brief rundown about this show. Community was created by Dan Harmon, and it ran from 2009 to 2014, originally airing on NBC, the first through the fifth season, and then the final season was on Yahoo Screen. Oh yes, Yahoo had a network streaming service. I don't know, is it still up? Is that still a thing? Is Yahoo still a thing? Yahoo knows. Anyway, the show basically was about a band of lovable misfits getting into all sorts of shenanigans at their community college. There's a lovable and very odd dean, Ken Jeong, who just like started out as one character, and by the end we were like, I'm sorry, this man needs help.
I got this.
All you're making me feel right now is hatred of Renee Zellweger.
Actual help. But honestly, every neckbeard on the internet has made a video talking about how great community is, why we should all worship at the altar of Dan Harmon and the Russo brothers. So honestly, just look up community on the internet. You'll find a video going through more detail about the show. And I mostly agree because, like I said, it's the jam. Why do I say so much on this channel? Because it's such a great show, during lockdown, I found out that it was back on Netflix and I was like,
oh bitch, it's time to start watching Community again. It's been a year, let's do it.
So I'm watching it, reliving the best moments, Troy and Abed in the morning, you know, Annie's boobs. Like, it was just a good time. And then, to my dismay, I'm thinking back while I'm watching and I realize, I said to myself, self, is there an episode missing here? And I was like, maybe it was in season three. Maybe I'm just misinterpreting. So I watched season three and I still can't find this episode. The episode in question, my dears, is Advanced Dungeons and Dragons. So I did what any sensible person would do. I hit up Google and I was like, hey girl, what's going on? Where's Advanced Dungeons and Dragons? What's happening? Come to find out, or as we say in Walla, fake until war, Netflix and Hulu, we don't have Hulu in Canada, we just have Netflix. Netflix got rid of it. Excusez-moi, je suis dégoûté. Is it dégoûté? Dégoûtant. Je suis dégoûtant. I was disgusted. I don't know how to say that properly in French. Somebody will correct me. Either way. So I found out it was deleted and I was super annoyed because I was like, why? And then as I was doing the Googles, it was because of the blackface.
What the actual f-?
Okay, so I showed y'all the scene. If it didn't get copyrighted, then I did show it to you. If it did get copyrighted, then I'll explain it right now. This whole episode it's about the impacts of bullying, and it's actually a really touching story, and it shows how evil Pierce was as a character, and just is a great episode. It's written really well. There aren't any special effects in it, but it's still very compelling storytelling. At the very beginning, Ken Jeong's character comes in. Ooh, my laundry's done. At the beginning, Ken Jeong's character comes in and he is in like tar black all over his body, not just his face, his entire body, in a white wig because he is an elf. And Dan Harmon jokes that this is before Game of Thrones, so NBC was kind of like, why? There's a lot of goblin in this script. What's going on, girl? But anyway, he comes in and the minute he sits down, Shirley's like,
so we just gonna ignore that hate crime, huh?
And it's so funny. Eventually, Ken Jeong's character dies at the very beginning. Like, he doesn't really, his character, the Dungeons and Dragons character, doesn't last that long in the episode. So it's just like for a few minutes of it. Basically, Netflix pulled it, Hulu pulled it, and Sony's talked about how they were in support of Netflix pulling this episode. And that's what I really want to talk about, because what on earth is wrong with y'all? And I know I'm late to the party because this happened last year in June. But we just need to talk about this performative activism with a lot of these companies, this corporate virtue signaling, because that's what this really was. I am not gonna stand here and act like I am the monolithic voice of all black people saying that it wasn't offensive for this character to be in blackface, or saying that black people don't care. I'm not gonna be like,
I'm black and I didn't care, so it shouldn't matter.
No, because everyone is different. Some black people are fine with it and some weren't, whatever. My problem with it is that, one, I didn't find it offensive. Two, they made it a joke to acknowledge it. And three, Community, if we want to talk about Community being offensive or pulling episodes, there are way more episodes that could have been pulled. Community might be more homophobic than racist, if we're being honest. Like, come on.
Penis! Two penises! Oh, this is gay! It's okay!
Every other episode there's a gay joke, or within the episode, you know what I'm saying? So I really feel like they were just trying to, oh, the blacks are angry, so now we gotta come up and figure out how to show that we're good people. You know what you could have done, Netflix? Maybe stop filming all of your TV shows in Atlanta, where the government there is really, really just leaning heavy into this voter suppression shit. Maybe stop that. And I do recognize that it wouldn't be that great if Netflix stopped filming stuff there, because other people would, and also people need jobs, so it's kind of like a, would you call it a catch-22? I get that. But either way, a lot of corporations I find, especially with entertainment and TV shows, really want to make it seem like they're doing the good work. Like, everyone was all pissed off last year when people got rid of Gone with the Wind, because some people are saying,
oh, everyone's too sensitive, like it's an American classic.
Other people are saying,
it should be there to show what racist depictions of Black people were like at that time.
And other people are like, nah, get rid of her, girl. Bye. We don't need her. There are plenty. We don't need a film to remind us that America was racist. And all of those points, I think, are valid to an extent. I don't like when people dismiss people getting offended by something just by saying they're too sensitive, because to me, I always believe that people will be offended by whatever they will be offended by, and that's their right. Like, but what Netflix and Hulu did was not an apology. It wasn't a learning opportunity. It wasn't anything. It was them just reacting and saying, oh, last thing we want to do is get canceled, so we're just going to pull the episode, and there it is. So I wanted to just add before I go into all of this that while I still stand by the point of not really believing that this is the blackface that people think it is, there is an argument. Sorry, there's construction going on underneath me. There is an argument to be made for why these elves need to have dark skin. Why do these elves need to be Black? And therefore, why are they seen as evil or lesser class? And Games with Greg did a really great video going more in depth with that. So I will link it below. I really recommend y'all check it out because it seems like he is also a fan of this show and this episode, but is using that critical lens of why people would be upset about this. For me, I think we can hold space for both arguments and hold space for that tension within this, because I think that this is not the blackface people think it is, but I also am aware that there is a discussion to be had about why dark elves exist and why they're seen in this way and the inspirations. Like, Games with Greg goes into the inspirations of a lot of these fantasy things. People like H.P. Lovecraft, who we know was racist. He had a cat named the N-word. Like, we know H.P. Lovecraft was hella racist, but anyway, I really recommend y'all check that out, especially if you don't agree with all the points that I made in this video, because Greg goes into it a bit more in depth. Me, I'm just trying to focus this on why Netflix missed an opportunity of discussing, sorry, this construction, why Netflix missed an opportunity of having more of a conversation instead of just getting rid of something like this, because there's more nuance to be had in fantasy, in race, in fantasy, and blackface. Anyway, back to the vid. Part of the process, I think, of educating yourself when it comes to these topics is learning enough about them to recognize when things are I don't want to say actually happening, but kind of when those things are actually happening, and by things I mean blackface, versus when there's just a different commentary that could be misconstrued as that. So what I mean by that is I did a whole video essay talking about digital blackface, and I titled it Digital Blackface with a question mark because I was even like, is this digital blackface? Are people just doing too much? What's going on here? I spent the entire video essay, I gave history, context, talking about the evolution of blackface, what it actually was, how it evolved into present day, sort of, how we could see it as memes. And I spent most of it talking about AAVE and, you know, linguistic minstrelsy, but a lot of people like to not watch the whole video and just get mad about the fact that I was talking about memes, where if they actually watched the full video, they'd know that most of my focus was about white people and basically non-Black people in general using AAVE and then getting sick of the terms that we bring into the culture, especially queer POCs, and then all of a sudden deciding to cancel certain terms. Anyway, you watch it if you want to. The reason that I went so in depth with the topic was because I was like, there is no reason for me to get on the internet, talk about digital blackface, and just tell people, oh, this is why you shouldn't use reaction gifs. Because yeah, some people that will just listen to whatever someone says, they're gonna be like, oh, you shouldn't do that. I watched this video of this Black person talking about it. But a lot of other people are gonna wanna know why exactly is that the case. A lot of other people are gonna want the lines drawn, are gonna want you to do the work of putting the pieces together. And as someone who likes to learn about topics and share the information that I learn, I don't mind doing that work most of the time. So to me, and as well, because I like when I read certain things that people publish or that people produce or anything, or watch, I guess, where they're actually giving you the parallels, where they're showing you historical connections and giving more context, because to me that helps make my argument or my education and understanding more well-rounded. But what Netflix and Hulu did was not making the education, they didn't even provide education one, but it wasn't making any of it well-rounded. They were just canceling it. Meanwhile, movies like Tropic Thunder, which is actual blackface, because minstrelsy is not just, I want people to also understand, minstrelsy is not just about painting your face black. It is also about the attitude that you exude, the caricaturization. That's not a real word. The caricaturization. That's not a real word, but we're just gonna use it for now. It's also about that aspect of things. When people were putting on blackface, they weren't just wearing black tar or melted down cork, putting it on their face and being like, I'm black now, ha. They were doing these over-exaggerated vocal effects as well, and movements and mannerisms to pretend to be black people. It's not just making fun of black people, it's making fun of the essence of what it means to be black, AKA flattening blackness into this is how black men act, this is how certain black women act, bing, bang, bong, here you go. And acting like that, AKA turning us into a monolith, as opposed to recognizing that black people are humans, but you know what, we're just gonna, So the reason that I say high education is because if Netflix, if anyone in Netflix was aware of that, if anyone that was in charge of removing that episode was aware of the fact that blackface is not just about painting your face black. It's also about making fun of the essence of what white people, or how white people, especially at that time, view blackness and black people. They would have been able to say, actually, if people came at them, were like, we're canceling, we don't want this episode, remove it, Netflix, what are you doing, blah, 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 blah. They could have come to people and been like, hey, we hear your concerns, we understand this, but this is why we are keeping this episode in, because blah, 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 blah. And if they didn't want to be the people to do it, if they wanted to actually, I don't know, hire a black person or someone who specializes in this to talk, and by specialize, I mean just historians, to talk about this and speak to why this isn't blackface, I would have appreciated that, you know, because I think there is this really, it's very easy for people to, the minute somebody gets online and their skin is darkened and stuff like that, to immediately call it blackface. And I know that everything is on a case by case basis, because blackfishing is a thing. And I appreciate that people have termed it blackfishing and not blackface, because it's different. I think if Netflix had actually taken the time to teach themselves, their staff, all of this, the history of blackface, educating themselves, and then being able to, if anyone came at them being like, ah, blah, 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 having actual context for it. And I'm not saying, not mansplain, but do you know what I mean? I'm not saying like, tell someone that they can't be offended by it or whatever, but just actually open a dialogue, it would have served them better. This could have actually turned into a conversation about, okay, blackface. We're not trying to necessarily gatekeep what blackface is or isn't, but let's talk about what it actually was, what it is, how it's evolved, and what this episode did. And does it actually, do we actually consider it falling under the category of blackface, or are we just succumbing to the peer pressure that we see around us because we just don't want to be canceled? And instead of actually doing the education and the work to learn why somebody would even think about canceling us, we're just going to take the episode out so that nobody even has to worry about it. Like, to me, I just feel like it was a really missed opportunity. And just at first I was nervous about even saying that or coming on YouTube and saying that, because last thing I wanted to be was that Negro that was like, Dan Harmon is good and they did a great episode. Because like, I'm not sitting here acting like Community is the best show in the world. Like, one of my friends, her partner and I always talk about Community. We love it, whatever. They do not love it. And she was like, I don't get it, blah, blah, blah. And her partner was like, oh, Khadija likes it, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, girl, you don't have to like Community. Not every black person is gonna like it. And she brought up valid concerns about the show. And I was like, yes, I totally get it. Part of the reason why I still love it though, is because for me, it's for nostalgia as well. And nostalgia is a hell of a drug. You know what I'm saying? Like, look at all the reboots, I'm just saying. It has a special place in my heart for many different layers. And I can acknowledge that there are some things in the show, in the writing, all of this that are a bit like, But I don't know, just watching the show, rewatching it, and even watching a panel that they all did a couple of years ago, Yvette Nicole Brown, oh, angel, she talks about how in one of the episodes, originally they had this idea where they were going to have Shirley, her character, attempt to shit in this woman's desk. And Shirley was like, Yvette Nicole Brown was like, oh no, we cannot do that. Like, I know this show isn't for Black Christian women of a certain age, but the few that are watching, if I do this, we gonna lose them. So she says she was nervous to go talk to her boss, Dan, and be like, hey, I don't really think this is. And he says, you know,
I said, you know, we should find something else, please, sir. And he was kind enough to come up with the hose in the drawer.
Yeah.
So thank you.
It's funny to even think that there would be a debate, you know, like nowadays, if you came to my office and said, Black woman, I'd be like, huh? Yeah. Don't cancel me.
Listen.
But yeah, even something like that showed me that there seemed to have been, apart from, you know, the stuff that we heard about Chevy and all of that, there seemed to have been a very good working relationship with the cast and crew and all of that stuff. And obviously I wasn't there, I don't know, but it seems like that was a case. So to me, it seems like if they were gonna do a Ken Jeong in blackface and they have at least two main cast members who are Black, that will have different experiences, come from different points of view, whatever. I'm sure that at some point there, I hope that there would have at least been a conversation within them to know, hey, is this not hitting right? Are we, what's going on? Do you know what I mean? Yes, there are a lot of issues with community, with any show that you watch, especially any show that was created in the 2000s, even if it's a late 2000s. Y'all, we didn't have common sense, okay? I'm just saying. When I was listening to the read, when I had found out that this happened, at one point, Kid Fury is talking about how he is annoyed that they got rid of this episode. And I was like, thank God, because I was like honestly nervous coming out being like the Black person that defends blackface, quote unquote. But to me, I trust my learning and my education and my commitment to continued education to know that, for me at least, knowing the history and the context and all of this, for the most part, I'm not gonna say I get it right every time, but I am aware of what blackface is. And Ken Jeong pretending to be a elf as a character and Shirley straight up being like, so he's gonna ignore his hate crime and like them acknowledging that he's an elf. To me, I just was like, this is not it. And I think Kimberly Foster for Harriet had said this, and I really appreciated it. Though it's not my full belief, I do appreciate and understand it, is that a lot of us depend on media or whatever to do what therapy should or what policy should. And I do think that media and stuff like that is culture making. And I think that it is valuable and important to see yourself reflected and represented, and not just represented in terms of numbers, but represented in a holistic way, represented in a compassionate way, and also sometimes in just a fun way, you know, like how many times are we tired of seeing Black struggle stories? Like, I completely believe that representation matters on many different levels, but I also hold another truth within that, that the representation can't fix everything. And so as a result, this seeming misrepresentation of blackface or whatever, this is not the problem. This episode of Community is not the problem. If we're thinking systemically, if we want to actually have change, it's not the problem. And there are many other TV shows and movies that actually do have blackface. I said Tropic Thunder, you know, like, Robert Downey Jr. wasn't just in brownface. He was also using a voice and pretending to use an affect of a Black man. To me, that is much more closely related, if not actually blackface minstrelsy, than Ken Jeong being tar Black with a white wig as an elf. Like, do you know what I'm saying? Like, it's just different. And I know some people could maybe argue then, what was the point of even having him be that color? Why couldn't he have been yellow or something like that? I don't know. I don't know Dungeons and Dragons, so I don't know if that's actually, like, Dan Harmon apparently was played Dungeons and Dragons as a teen. So maybe he actually knew that there are actually elves that look this way. And maybe that's something to speak to the greater racial implications of why these elves are Black and blah, blah, blah. Like, we could, the layers, the holes we could go into are so deep, it's not even funny. But I think just in terms of this episode, What I'm more so speaking about is the fact that Netflix and Hulu decided to just remove it as opposed to leaving the possibility for people to discuss and using it as a learning opportunity, not just for the people that would maybe be opposed to the episode staying on their platforms, but also for their staff and for themselves. And in the little bits of articles that I was reading, I don't know if Dan Harmon has said anything about this episode. I'm sure he's just probably like, listen, I'm a white dude. I'ma just take it out. I'ma just listen.
Centering black voices.
I'm gonna just listen. You know? So I don't know what his thoughts are on this, but I just wanted to say this because, again, I love Community. It is one of my favorite shows ever. I understand that there are so many different problems with it. I understand that it's not, it's a bit dicey at times, but I just think it was so ahead of its time. I think it was written so smartly. I think it's just so entertaining. The homage episodes are so brilliant. It's like watching a movie every episode, but it's like a comedy movie. And, you know, six seasons in a movie, I haven't given up hope. I'm still waiting. I know Donald Glover would be really expensive, but six seasons in a movie. Let's start the campaign again, y'all. Anyway, this is, you know, if there are more TV shows that I can talk about or episodes that maybe people have reacted to in a way that, I mean, don't flood my mentions. Leave it in the comments. Don't necessarily DM me. Because like I said, I'm not going to be out here doing too much with the DMs. But, you know, I think TV shows do have a lot of power, I believe. And I think it is important that we consume and critique responsibly. But at the same time, you know, like I say, you can hold two things to be true at the same time. Or multiple things. And I think we can still have fun. You know, I think it is very hard, especially in this time, to enjoy and just watch things. And I know, because as someone who's always like thinking and up here, it is hard. And even when I tell people, oh, my downtime, I watch Community. People are like, that's still not just like some lighthearted, like dummy show. Like Community still has a lot of thought behind it. And there's a lot of intelligence within the humor. So for me, that's my downtime kind of humor. You know, it's still very smart, but it is still just very funny. And I think they could have really used this, Netflix and Hulu specifically, as a learning opportunity and as a way to actually start a conversation as opposed to just getting rid of the episode. Because part of the thing that I think is an issue with this time period that we live in is that it is much easier to just cancel things, like literally cancel the episode or decide not to engage with something that might make us feel a certain way, which I get, because sometimes you just need to take care of yourselves. But it's a lot easier to do that than to engage in conversations that might be uncomfortable, like to a certain degree. I will talk to people that I don't have the same opinion with to a certain degree. I'm not gonna argue the reality of Black Lives Mattering, or I'm not gonna argue with a Nazi about their stand, you know, like there are certain things that's a boundary that I'm gonna set. I'm not gonna argue with people like that. But if you disagree about certain policies or things like that, or certain TV shows, or don't understand certain sensitivities to certain things, I can disagree with you and have a conversation and either come to a consensus or come to a, oh, we kind of see each other's perspective. We're still gonna disagree, but hey, thanks for engaging. And I think we could use a little bit more of that, which is hard because it takes a lot of emotional labor and it's exhausting. But I think it would actually help us be a bit better and help us, you know, not immediately write off TV shows for jokes that actually work and aren't the thing that people are claiming they are just because they read like a random BuzzFeed article and now they think they know everything about blackface, I guess. Like, I don't know. I don't even know. Like, my biggest question is, who asked Netflix to cancel this episode? Because I couldn't really find anything. And like I said, this was light research for this video. But if y'all know, can you comment below? Because I actually don't know if there was even an uproar of people being like,
Netflix better cancel this episode because how dare they do blackface?
Like, I actually don't know. Like, Kid Fury's probably the only other person that I heard talk about this episode and had the same gripe I did, which was like, why the fuck? I love that episode. Why the fuck? So yeah, I hope y'all enjoyed this video. A little bit of light work, you know, a little bit of light content. Make sure to check the description. I don't think I have that much in the description, but also make sure to check the pinned comment for my small channel shoutouts for June. And this is the last video that I'm advertising the charity that we are doing for the month of June. Next month is going to be a different charity. So check the description for that. It's the PayPal link and all that. Like I said, if it seems sketchy, go directly to the charity and donate there. All good. I think we've raised probably $600 or $700 at time of filming this video, which is at the beginning of June. So who knows what it's at now. Yeah, as always, feed your plets, water your plets, and remember that you can always change your mind because you can. You're allowed, okay? You're allowed to. Don't let anybody be out here trying to tell you that you're not allowed to change your mind because you are. I will see y'all in the next one. Bye. Hey, community.
He would later say of the war, it was awesome, but also, it wasn't.
Hello and welcome. I don't know why I screamed.
Before you can say 1984, the thought police are forcing you to bend and spread.
Was it seven? Pierce.
But are the thought police gonna make love to us?
Do they find thoughts in our butts? I knew I should have read that book.
I do Pierce first.
Gay!
Mixture of, oh, why is this piece?
Wow, did you know Greendale students are technically in the Army Reserves?
Pierce, Troy, Jeff, Abed, Annie, Britta.
Let's say a little prayer for peace.
Oh my God, you know you can sense, I just got you. Oh, okay, hold on.
We're trying to get Jeff ready for the fight.
Tell me why.
Gay marriage!
The lighting is an asshole. Tell me why.
What is that?
It's probably the monkey that lives in the vents.
I just want to know.
Greendale's music department is flat baroque.
Why?
I am the least racist person in the world. My best friend, when I was 6 years old, was a black man.
Why the lighting?
Simple, really. First we...
You're warming up. I just need you to focus on my face.
Abed, what did I tell you? You can't just mumble nonsense. No one's cutting away.
Okay, fine.
Tell me why.
You need to be someone else. Someone who eventually gets a girlfriend.
Focus on me, baby girl. That's right, right here. Okay.
Because I can't think of anything more frightening than a half Polish, half Arab virgin in his 30s.
I don't know why to lie.
One way or the other, that story ends with an explosion.
It's here. I'm just getting paranoid.
Welcome back, Jeffrey. How was your...
Show's gonna last 3 weeks!
6 seasons and a movie!